Senator Valencia.
Good morning. It is still morning. Great to be here. Nobody knows better than folks from the 4th Congressional District the damage that liberal policies do. Whether policies of state government that stick children in schools that aren't performing, that aren't graduating people that can read and write at grade level and pursue the American dream, or whether it's cities and counties that take away your liberties and your freedoms and require you to do things that you don't want to do. As I said, my name is Dave Thompson, and I like to be judged by decisions that I make. I think good leaders make good decisions, and that's why I selected Michelle Benson as my running mate. Yes. She will not be put in a back closet, or as I like to say, she will not be Prettner Solund. She is going to work in the healthcare area. She is going to help extract us from Minsure. Yes. She is going to help us push back against Obamacare and get exceptions to the mandates and requirements so that we can restore medical care into the hands of doctors and patients rather than bureaucrats and insurance companies. We are going to make as a priority of this campaign education. And what that means, folks, is that there needs to be choice. And I mean true, bold choice. I don't mean a little tiny bit around the edges. I mean a tuition tax credit or a scholarship that allows people to have the money follow students, not follow buildings. We're going to accomplish that. Finally, the economy. We are going to get our regulatory state under control. People ask me, how can you get the Pollution Control Agency, the Commerce Department, and other departments under control? The answer is, the chief executive sets the tone. We want to be welcoming to business. We want to congratulate and thank entrepreneurs rather than creating a class warfare that pits one group of Minnesotans against another. That is not the American way, and this administration will not do that. But let me talk for a moment about something else. You got to select a candidate here 5 weeks from today for governor. How are we going to win? Because I will tell you, since 2012, I have run into some discouraged people. And I know that back in 2012, we had some elections coming out of the 2011 and 12 legislative sessions. That time, we did some things wrong and we divided people, even within our own party. This time, it's going to be different. That time, we didn't realize the damage that could be done by total Democrat control of the legislature and the governor's office. But this time, we do. So here's what I'm asking of you. Of course, I'm asking for your vote. And I'm asking for your support of the convention. I will be honored by that. By the way, if I don't get your support, because I respect you and I respect this process, I will abide by your endorsement and I will support this election. You see, the last time we weren't all rowing in the same direction, but this time I want you to promise me that it will be different. That whoever that candidate is, and I sincerely want it to be Michelle and me, but if it's not, I will join with you. And I want you to join with me, because the ultimate opponent is an ideology and a belief system that elevates government over the individual rather than making the individual the top of our hierarchy. Yes. Many of you are familiar with me because back when I was on the radio and back when I did TV commentary, I came to the 4th Congressional District a lot. I came to Minneapolis and St. Paul. A vote here matters as much as a vote anywhere else in Minnesota. And nobody needs conservative policies and reform more than the people that populate this room. And we're gonna do the best that we can to get that for you. So I ask for your support. I ask for your vote. I thank you so much for being here. Have a great convention. Let's replace Mark Dayton. Let's win the House. Let's get Al Franken back to Hollywood. Thank you so much. Thank you.